Hi, welcome to Ask an Expert. My name's Chris Johnston. I'm the president of Sierra-Olympia Technology, and in this video, we're going to talk about F-number, and F-number specifically as it relates to infrared optic. The first thing I want to discuss about F-number is its fundamental formula. It's a very simple formula. Basically, F number is the ratio of the focal length of a lens divided by the diameter of the lens. If you think about a lens with an F number of 1, that means that the diameter of your lens is equivalent to the focal length. So if you have a 300 millimeter focal length lens, you have a 300 millimeter diameter lens. How does F number impact an infrared system? It goes primarily back to that issue of the diameter. The diameter governs how efficient light or energy makes it through a lens. So if you have a big diameter lens, you're getting lots of light or energy through that lens. So it's always a ratio of the diameter of the optic and the light collection efficiency and the focal length or the reach you want to get out of a lens, how far away you want to see. Of course, longer focal lengths give you longer range imaging. Shorter focal lengths are generally wide field of view applications, but used for short range imaging. So always keep in mind focal length, diameter, and light collection efficiency. Another impact of F-number is in the resolution capability of a lens. There's a fundamental formula in spherical optics called the airy disk formula or the blur circle formula. It has to do with a constant, 1.22 times the wavelength of the light that you're operating in. We operate in the midwave in 3 to 5, in the long wave 8 to 12, microns, and then the F number. So the airy disk, meaning the blur circle, how much diffractive blur you're going to get on a point source coming through the lens onto the sensor, is a simple mathematical formula of 1.22 times the wavelength of light times the F number. When designers approach lens designs with low F numbers, the tolerances and the manufacturability of a lens becomes much more difficult. We would all like low F number, long focal length lenses. But in the real world, when it comes to the cost of the exotic glass that goes into an infrared lens, it's either silicon or germanium or zinc selenide or chalcogenides. These are really expensive materials. The difficulty of manufacture of low F-number optics in terms of diamond turning and polishing and defects and alignment, those add up to considerable cost factors that eventually make a lens too expensive and impractical. And not only that, too big and heavy even to use. So again, the factor of manufacturability and F number is critically important. We also have to go over issues related to long wave sensors, sensor sensitivity, and midwave sensors as well. And I'll see you in a future Ask an Expert video. Thanks for watching.